We now place ourselves in the presence of God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the heart of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in his consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory
to you, O Lord.
To you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away and I will come back to you. If you love me, you will rejoice that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe. I will no longer speak much with you, for the ruler of the world is coming. He has no power over me, but the world must know that I love the Father and that I do just as the Father has commanded me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you. Good afternoon, good morning, and good evening.
Good evening, Father.
In John 14, we have the beautiful message of the Lord when he said, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you." It's a beautiful proclamation. It's a beautiful assurance of the Lord. It's a wonderful message. Peace is given to all of us. You realize that after the resurrection, peace is the guarantee of the Lord, is the statement of the Lord. He means it. He wants to give peace to everybody, to his disciples, to the women around, to all the people around, and to all the world. Peace is a universal language. And peace perhaps is tantamount to love or the power of love. And so in the context of peace that we love, in the context of peace that we understand each other, in the context of peace that we are in harmony with each other, reconciled with each other, so much so that the world can be reconciled through the peace of Jesus Christ. And Father said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away and will come back to you." The same thing that the Lord is telling us. He will go away and come back to us because he loved us. He will go away and prepare a place for us. And as soon as he prepared for us, he will come back and take us with him so that where he is, there might we be also. And so the beautiful message of this gospel happens again to us. It's the peace that is proclaimed by the Lord. It is the peace that the Father gives. It is the peace that they give to us, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And that with the peace around, we can be reconciled. We can be truly at home. We can be truly with the Father. We can truly be the Son and the Holy Spirit. Peace I give you. It's the guarantee of a life of reconciliation, of service, of love to humanity. So hopefully we have that peace. Hopefully our hearts are not burdened with anything else. Hopefully our life will be at peace with everybody, because when we are at peace, we go forth with the teachings of Jesus. We go forth with the commandment of Jesus, but that commandment is the commandment of the Father. And so the Spirit will tell us everything we do. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
For the peace you proclaim to us.
For the peace that you've given to us.
Truly, it's a great commandment.
Proclaim to us.
Truly.
And it's a commandment that honors your power.
And it's a commandment that honors the power.
Peace is the fruit of love.
Peace is the fruit of love.
And we are when we are at peace.
When we are at peace,
we are reconciled with everybody.
We are reconciled with everybody.
And with you.
And with you.
We are at home with everybody.
We are at home with everybody.
And with you.
And with you.
We are in communion with each one.
We are in communion with each one.
And above all, with the Father.
And above all, with the Father.
Thank you, Lord, for this peace.
Thank you, Lord, for this peace.
That is the longing of our hearts.
That is the longing of our hearts.
The longing of our being.
The longing of our being.
And our wholesomeness.
And our wholesomeness.
Because when we are not at peace,
Because when we are not at peace,
we look for other things.
We look for other things.
Things that are detrimental to you, O Lord.
Things that are detrimental to you, O Lord.
And many times we could not contain ourselves.
And many times we cannot contain ourselves.
But peace within us.
But peace within us.
Make us your children. And make us your faithful followers.
And make us your faithful followers.
And faithful disciples.
And faithful disciples.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Angel of God,
my guardian angel,
Saint Anthony, pray for us. Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Send, O Lord.
Pray for us.
Holy apostles into your church.
Lord, be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Good evening.
Good evening, Father. Thank you very much.
Good evening. Wow.
Peace be with you all.
Peace be with you.
I ask, yung pilgrimage, may it be ba na after sa longing to be the ruler of the world, that the true ruler is there, up there, no?
Mm-hmm. Yes. We have Jesus as our ruler, the Father.
Father, there was a... something in the internet last night, there was a message from Jude, that's Jovi, that we have to pray hard because in, where is that part of the Philippines now, that they're sending troops to protect the Philippines against China?
Gin Google ko, hindi ko nakita ang news.
Not true.
Pang-panic lang yan.
Pwede na siguro true, pwede na hindi. But we have to pray for the Philippines. We have to pray for our nation.
Yeah.
Either way, if it is there, you know, we have to pray more.
We need
hopefully, it's not there.
For peace, but Father, no? For peace talaga. We need more prayer.
Yes.
Yeah.
Opa.
Especially with that in Iran. Yes. Opa. Israel. Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yeah,
the Holy Land is being attacked.
The peace of Jesus is offering though is inner peace.
And they said, no, sa isang humilis, no, na peace is not the absence of war.
Yeah.
It, oh, peace is not in only the absence of challenges. War. Yeah. Mm.
Yes, precisely.
Inner peace.
Yeah,
inner
very
peace.
True.
Okay, Jesus.
Inner peace, yeah.
Inner peace.
The individual inner peace that we have for ourselves also.
So inner peace, but also external peace.
Yeah, inner peace. Yeah.
Do not be afraid. 365 times yun, Father, no? Sa Bible.
Do not be afraid. Wow. Almost every day. Grabe ang assurance, no? Grabe ang assurance na binigay sa atin. Do not be afraid.
Sometimes, Father, physically we have some these physical ailments that we have. You really cannot help, but when you pray, pray hard, really. But then it comes back and it again attacks, like it attacks like a hypertensive attack, or physical numbness of the any part of the body.
Anxiety attack.
But we really cannot help sometimes, Father. We really, I should confess, it sometimes bothers na though Jesus has already time and time again assured us that there will be, that we should not fear, but this fear really as a human being is very consistent with each and individual.
They come.
Yeah. You cannot help.
Yes,
no?
Mm-hmm.
Human.
And
human
we could
nature.
Not get away from it. There are those who are really in pain of sickness, of health, and many other things in life. But for those who believe in the Lord, those things are becoming silent witnesses of our life.
True, Father. I always, you know, assure myself that, yes, Lord, you are with me. I must not fear. But then sometimes I would think of those who went into, yung nag-ermitanyo, Father. They went into such a place na they would have the peace that they want because they're alone with God in there, with the environment around inside the cave or wherever they want to spend their whole life. Or the, yun ay, ano yan, physical peace yun, Father? At
inner peace.
Inner peace, no?
Yes. But because you others have difficulties also. But others have difficulty also, Tita. It's not peace immediately. But along the line, they manage to experience peace from God. But of course, the beginning, really, it's a tremendous pain, tremendous hardship for them. So wherever we are, there are a lot of this. Well, yoga is another thing. It could be an exercise. It could be a religion. It could be depending on the person.
Mind control, Bex. And yoga, meditation and mind control.
So it's different. Is the Catholic Church
using that one?
Not condoning
the Catholic
it, but...
Church does not condone it. It could be a meditation. It could be a way of life for you. But of course, for the Catholic, it's not the way of life that we are using.
Yeah.
Ang yoga kasi is also meditation, no? And you control your mind, no? How you feel, mga ganyan ba? And then it's like a praying also with deep meditation, no? Na entrust everything to God. Yun ang sa Catholic siguro na deep meditation tayo and then entrust everything. And then once
contemplation.
Contemplation. Once you achieve that, no, you will have peace. Kasi nga at peace kayo, you believe and you have faith, you trust everything to God. You have faith that everything will be okay as He promised. Or if not okay, no, he will be with us. Yun ang peace na between yoga. Nagka-practice kasi ako ng yoga noon. Between yoga, mm-hmm. meditation, between yoga and meditation. It's all about inner, something, inner communication. Ang sa yoga is control.
Mind control.
Oh, mind control.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay lang pala yan.
But don't call it yoga, that's okay. Deep meditation.
Huh?
It changed mo lang ang terminology, huwag lang yung yoga. So, ah. Deep meditation, communication.
Okay. Kasi sa charismatic world daw, Father, hindi daw pinapayagan.
Yes. Kasi may kanya-kanyang terms sila.
Yeah.
So the charismatic world will use the meditation, the contemplation if they have, but of course really meditation is one of it. So they don't use other languages that would contradict.
Yung born again okay. is also another, no, Father?
Uh-huh. Yes, another religion, another faith that is given to the world but not to us.
Yeah.
Unless you are born again, sabi ng St. John.
Unless you are born again, doon siguro kinuha yung born again.
Yeah, precisely. Yeah. Precisely.
Doon nga.
No?
Yes, so po.
And it made Nicodemus baffled.
Yeah, di ba? Kasi si Lerma, oh.
So we have the peace of the Lord proclaimed to us. It's for us to get it. But for us really to exercise that peace, it's not the absence of war, but it's an element within us that looks for Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Amen. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. Good morning.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you. Love you, Father.
Love you all.
Good night.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, the peace in the secular world is avoidance of trouble and a refusal to face unpleasant things. However, Jesus promised to give us his peace that the world cannot give. Number two, in this peace of Christ, even though we may be surrounded by sorrow, pain, and suffering, Jesus' spirit that is within us will conquer all the fears and anxieties of our lives if we dare to trust him. Number three, in the eyes of the world, the cross stood for shame, humiliation, and defeat. However, in the cross of Christ, we find true peace and reconciliation with God. Pray for this peace that the world cannot rob you of. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tita Lynn.
Amen.
Welcome. Yeah. Any other thought? Anybody? Short lang.
We always strive to do things in order for our Master, our Lord, to be, to be happy about us. Pero yun lang ang kakayahan natin, paano yan. So, hindi natin ma-achieve really, no? There is...
Iba ang worldly peace. Worldly peace is different from the peace that Jesus promised us. Oh.
Iba talaga.
Oh. So ang Jesus promised us this kind of peace, no, that we can achieve every day, no, that we are urged or command of Jesus Christ, no, na to have this peace, no, is to love one another, to be compassionate, faithfulness to the moral law, yun ang mga ano, mga challenges of God, no? And then by choosing the will of God, yun maka-achieve tayo ng peace that He promised. It's not the absence of war, it's not the absence of chaos or whatever, non-worldly. Iba ang inner peace na gina-promise ni Jesus. So be faithful to His commandments, be faithful to the moral law, be faithful to the commandments, especially love one another, love, compassion, respect, and sharing. Yun ang mga maka-achieve sa atin ng inner peace. Amen.
Amen.
Do you have something, Belle? Do you have something from Father Tito?
It's actually the same na sinabi ni Father na at saka sa'yo na the peace that the Lord promised is not the absence of challenges or difficulties in our lives. And it's always the peace of God that will prevail. Remember that two times the disciples were challenged by fear when the Lord walked on the water and Peter sank because he lacked faith. Then the Lord was sleeping in the boat and there was a gull that beset them, and the disciples also were so afraid. So that's the Lord telling us that do not be afraid. And it is I. So his being with us is the source of our peace in this world. So the second point that Father Tito emphasized that is that what is really our mission? We must put importance on the achieving of the peace, and we gain this if we are at peace with one another too. That's a choice that we make, guided by the Holy Spirit and the peace of the Lord. Then the third is the peace that the Lord gives us. And that's really the most elusive peace that we are always looking for. That the peace that is very fulfilling, and it's actually following God's will. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Ben. Yeah, so.
Welcome.
Anything else, Tito Mans, if you have a short reflection?
Okay. Marinas, Das Marinas.
Yeah.
Many of us think that we will have peace by having power and wealth. That's why we aspire for it. We don't even care if we sin as long as we could have this corrupted wealth and power. But we must be wary for the reason that the devil has always a concession for us to have immoral wealth and power. And the concession is sin. And by accepting the offer of the devil, we are permanently under the devil's devious spell until we die and we end up in hell. On the contrary, Jesus offers us His peace, peace that no amount of worldly power and wealth could measure, peace that will keep us permanently away from sin, and peace that will plant contentment in our hearts. Therefore, we must embrace this peace that Jesus offers us. The question is, do you already have the peace of Jesus in your heart? You see, when we lose sometimes, even to us, we lose our peace when we have problems with our children, our husbands. See, can you say you have really peace of mind? Peace can only be had in the hearts of men. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tito Max. So let's be at peace with everybody in order to have this peace also. Be at peace with everybody.
Make peace.
Not war. Not chaos. Amen.
Amen. How can you achieve peace when there is no water? There's water shortage. That is a big problem.
You lose your peace of mind.
You say, Lord, please give us water. Kagaya ng mana from heaven ba? Ay, naku,
so Davao is given water because it's raining all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we run to Davao? We need a lot of money to ride in a plane, boat, or whatever to go to Davao in order to achieve, you know, peace and
water or rain is not only peace. I mean, there. Yeah, just yeah. Hindi yun inner peace. So anyway, just trust him, Bex. Yeah, yun yeah. Lang. Yeah.
Complete trust.
Have faith in him. Whatever his purpose is, kung bakit may drought, ina-remind lang tayo siguro. Why drought? Why?
To be gentle with the environment.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Amen. Thank you. Yeah. So thank you very much. And that ends our prayer meeting for today. No, beautiful reflection and insight of Father Danny and his prayer. No, and the beautiful insights and wisdom from all of you, from all of us. Let's have this peace, be at peace with everybody, and so that you will have peace, inner peace in your own heart. Amen.
Amen.
Mika Belen.
Yes. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time together. We ask that you would bless us and keep us in your care. May your peace, love, and joy fill our hearts and minds. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And
amen.
All together, please. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
It was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. Thank you guys. Bye.
Keep safe. Bye.